A life without shipping would be completely different. It's even hard to comprehend.
Every object you see around us right now, 80 to 95% of those objects has been shipped.
But it also has its dark sides.
5,000 container ships are solely responsible for 1% of the global CO2 emissions.
Set to double by 2050,
and this is where we come in. We're innovating on how to address the aerodynamics of any given ships. We could save up to 11 million tons of CO2 each year, an impact of $5 billion of saving.
There's no limitation in regards to where we want to take the project.
My name is Sangar.
My name is Léon Grillet. And we are the founders of BlueNose. For the past 50 years, one of the biggest strategies for shipowners to increase their efficiency has been to go through an economy of scale. We increase the volume of the ships, and by increasing those volumes, we make everything more efficient. This has left out one big component, which is air resistance, which still contributes between 10 to 15% to the fuel consumption of very big ships.
We cannot neglect air resistance anymore. BlueNose is innovating in structures that we install, that we retrofit on ships to reduce their air drag and thus reduce their fuel consumption. One of our main products is a wind deflector that we put at the front of the ships.
One of the main sources of losses on container ship in regards to the air resistance is located at the front of the ship, just in front of the first wall of container. Here you have an example of a ship of which we have generated a model from. So you can see air recirculation on that ship. And so at BlueNose, what we do is that we use the data from the ship owners that we work with, and we are able to generate optimized shapes. Once the shape is generated, we're able to build it and install it on board to basically prevent those same losses from occurring. And as you can see, there's a drastic difference in regards to how the air flows, especially in front of the ship. You can imagine, for example, a container ship having a variation of container heights and how the inflation and deflation of each of those modules is able to allow the adaptation to that variation of height, ensuring that we maintain optimal efficiency throughout the journey of the ship. Now that fuel prices have risen, it has become a very interesting avenue to pursue, both for economic reasons, but also for the environment. I mean, we are lucky enough to evolve in a space where fuel consumption and CO2 emissions are completely correlated. If we were to look at a container ship with a capacity of 8,000 containers, that would represent savings of about $1 million each year for a shipowner.
That's a win-win.
It's a win-win, yeah, it's a win-win.
Today, there are around 5,000 container ships that are viable for our solution.
Those 5,000 ships, they are solely responsible for 1% of global CO2 emissions. That's an incredible case of concentration of impacts.
So if we look at our core target, which are container ship, we could save up to 11 million tons of CO2 each year. To give you a comparison, that's almost 2.2 million cars off the roads each year.
So BlueNose is both a rational decision economically and environmentally.
Sustainability and profitability go hand in hand. It was really important in the design of our solution to make sure that it would be easily scalable.
When it comes to installing a solution, there's two avenues. There's the retrofitting avenue. This is the most obvious one to us for several reasons. The main one is the fact that the turnover of ships, so the new ships that are constructed every year, is actually quite low in regards to the total population. So most of the market is actually ships that have already been built and are going to still be in operation for the next 20 years.
If we had to wait for all the ships to be replaced, that would be too long and way longer than the time we can afford.
Of course, we don't leave out the idea of equipping ships directly at the shipyard, so new builds. And this is actually a process that is also quite easy for us to integrate.
We are going to deploy our first full-scale solution in the next 12 months. And after that would be commercialization at scale and finally see the real impact that we planned since we started and reach our full potential. There are definitely technologies that will help us a lot in the future, but until they come and are ready for the market, we need to act now.